Hey everyone, good to have you with us again. In this video, we're going to be discussing one of the most frequently cited indicators on the internet, namely the Supertrend Indicator. Now, the internet is full of articles about this indicator, but we've noticed that there is also some confusion. So in this video, we're going to shed some light onto the subject. One of the coaches at Unger Academy here, and as always, before we start, I invite you to please subscribe to our channel and also please leave us a like to this video as well. Hi, we are the Unger Academy, and we teach traders how to make money in the markets. Our founder, Andrea Unger, had been struggling with trading for years until he developed his automated trading method, which he used to become the only four-time world trading champion. Subscribe to our channel for free tips and tricks. All right, thank you so much. Okay, so let's start by explaining what the Supertrend Indicator is. So it's nothing more than the combination of two values, namely the mid price and the average true range. Now, what do we mean by mid-price? Well, mid-price is what I plotted on this chart. And basically, it's the average between the maximum and the minimum price of each bar. Now, you can see that for each bar, I plotted the midpoint of that bar. And then we'll add or subtract the average true range based on this mid-price. For simplicity, we can think of the average true range as the average of the bar ranges. That is to say, the average of the monetary swings of each bar. And this way, we get a kind of an upper and a lower channel, starting from the mid price and delineating exactly a price channel. But what is the Supertrend Indicator? Again, it's nothing more than the reproduction of these channels, but with particular rules. And here it is, it's plotted. And let's say we start from the top and then plot the indicator above the prices. Once the indicator starts, which is from this point, it can no longer increase in value. And you can see that the indicator can only decrease. So I'll take the minimum value, which has never been reached since we plotted the indicator above the prices. And after I reach the condition where the price closes above the indicator, as you see here on this bar, I'll start plotting the indicator using the lower channel. So mid price minus average true range. Following the same rule, the same mirror rule, in this case, I'll plot the indicator only for the values corresponding to the high of this channel that has been reached so far. Now from here, we'll draw the channel by precisely replicating the channel of the mid price minus the average true range. Then in case the level of the indicator moved down, we won't deviate and we'll maintain a continuous line. Now you can see here that the low goes above the indicator, but no close closes below this indicator. Now, in case there was a close below the indicator, and here is an example, we'll go back above it at some point and then draw the indicator above the prices. And I mean, that's it really. There isn't much more to add. We do need to mention what parameters are used for this indicator, namely the inputs, the degrees of freedom of the strategy. The parameters for the Supertrend are only two. The first parameter is the length of the average true range, which is the channel used to check the average true range. The default parameter is 10, which means that at this point, I'll average the last 10 ranges to add and subtract them, starting from the mid price. And after that, we have a second parameter, this one here, which is indicated as 3. And is simply the multiplier of this average true range. So to recap, when I reach a point starting from the mid price, I calculate the average of the last 10 ranges, and I add or subtract the value of this average multiplied by 3, which is the value of our multiplier. Starting from the mid price, adding 3 times the 10 period average true range, and subtracting 3 times the 10 period average true range. After that, the last step consists in drawing the indicator above the price line when there is a reversal signal, and then draw the indicator below the price line when the opposite happens. That is when the price crosses the indicator. With that, we're pretty much done with the theory. I mean, we are systematic traders, so what we need to do now is to test this indicator. And with what? Well, with a strategy that bases its entries precisely on the reversal of the positions predicted by this indicator. Now, we've prepared a straightforward strategy for this video that calculates the Supertrend Indicator through this function. which works exactly as I described to you before in this video. We have two inputs, the length of the ATR and the multiplier of the ATR. And this is followed by a parameter determining whether the indicator is plotted above or below the prices. If we are in an uptrend, the indicator will be drawn below the prices and therefore ST will be positive. If we were short and the indicator was plotted above the prices, this indicator would be negative. So if we went from a short to a long condition, namely if ST changes from negative to positive, we have the trigger for a long entry. And conversely, we have the trigger for a short entry. Once the triggers are set, we can enter orders with this small constraint, namely when the condition to go short occurs. I'll place a sell stop order at the low of the current bar. And conversely, I'll place it at the high of the current bar when we reach the long trigger. We can now load this strategy on a chart. And for this occasion, I prepared a chart with an hourly time frame for gold. I mean, we can use any time frame if we want, either the daily time frame, the 2-hour time frame, or the 1-hour time frame. I recommend that you don't go beyond that, so don't lower the time frame any further to 30, 15, or even 5 minutes, because that could lead to false entries due to market noise. But we entered the strategy with 10 and 3, the default parameters. And let's go and take a look at what the strategy would do in terms of performance. It would do nothing, I'd say. Yeah, I mean, we have quite an up and down period of performance, with an excessively lucky period in 2020, and then a terrible period in 2021 and 2022. So what we can do now is go and see if there are any parameters, namely an ATR length and an ATR multiplier, that could perhaps improve the performance of the indicator for this underlying at this time frame. So let's go and optimize the parameters, and we'll test all possible combinations of ATR length. So an ATR length from 5, let's say, to 60. Yeah, let's take it from 4 with steps of 2. And then we'll test the multiplier from 2 to, let's take 8 with steps of, say, 0.2. Right, now we'll get about 900 combinations that we'll process in less than 10 seconds. And that's it. I mean, we're almost done. Okay, so what do we get? So we sort by net profit, and we see that the first strategy made almost $300,000 with a drawdown of about $40,000. And take a look at the one in third place, which makes a little bit less profit, $250,000 with a drawdown of about $30,000. Okay, so let's try an example, which implies an average true range length of 18 and a multiplier of 5. And let's take a look at the equity line obtained. Okay, here it is. All right, so for starters, this looks like a lovely equity line. So we have just coded the inputs based on the indicator. The average trade, hey, it's excellent, because it lets us easily cover commission and slippage costs. We do about 50% of the trades long and 50% of the trades short. So the strategy is perfectly symmetrical in terms of both entry criteria and also as trades. Now let's take a quick look at this. The long side of the strategy is performing exceptionally well, and the short side does well as well. And there's a small negative trend in the first part. And if we look at the trend year by year, we see that we have all positive years and only 2010 is slightly negative. So can we consider the evolution of the system complete? No, well, definitely not. I want to remind you that we still don't have the position management in place here. And we haven't even entered a stop loss or a take profit. And we don't know, still how to manage the strategy from a money management perspective. And look, all these aspects are part of our daily work here at Unger Academy. And if you need help investing in the markets systematically and professionally, as we do, I recommend that you go and click on the link in the description of this video. And that's going to take you to a page where you can find several handy resources. There you can go and sign up for a free presentation by Andrea Unger. You can get our best-selling book, The Unger Method, by just covering the shipping costs, or you can even book a free call with a member of our team and have a completely free strategic consultation. And also, finally, I'd like to remind you to please subscribe to our channel if you haven't already done so, of course. And that way you'll be notified immediately when new videos and content are released. And of course, if you did find this content particularly useful, please, I invite you to leave us a like. With that, we will see you again soon with some new operational insights. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye for now.